Essentially, that's all like I like to think my work is about is composition and color, and everything besides that is somewhat secondary. So I think it's important that color strikes. Whether or not that color is necessarily considered bright, it has to somehow pop. I actually got started with art school by going for graphic design. And anyone who's been to art school knows that you generally start with some sort of foundation year, which involves pretty much hitting every different section. And then when I ended up moving to Paris, which I was intending on still doing, following that path into sculpture, I got to the sculpture department in Paris, and it was about a tenth of the size of the sculpture department that I was used to in San Francisco. And due to those constraints, I slowly found myself moving towards painting, which I didn't realize I had much of a passion for until then. One of my biggest pet peeves with art is that if you have to read something to understand or to appreciate what's there, then why doesn't that person just write something, you know? They should be a writer. And if you want somebody to be visually intrigued, then make something visually intriguing. Somebody can look at my work and absolutely adore it. And I have other people who contact me and think, you know, there's no message behind this. This is just paint, you know, like this is just colors and shapes, and which is exactly what I'm going for, and I love that. I like to get into places, because galleries are fantastic, and don't get me wrong, I'm always happy to show, but there's something great about going into a party where people aren't even expecting to necessarily see art and painting there. There's something about connecting with people on a level that doesn't include a gallery that's liberating in a way. Earlier, something I want to get into is a more community-based space, so that there's a lot of room to bounce ideas off people and collaborate. There's a lot of artists making art for people instead of for other artists, or instead of for collectors, or instead of for museums, and that's refreshing. The human form and the human face are probably on the top of my inspiration. Something I study quite constantly out and about. The way people compare themselves to other people, you know, it's all in a reflection, and it is all a reflection of ourselves in a way. Like, the way we feel about ourselves is obviously really closely paired a lot of times with the way we look at ourselves. The bigger picture is almost the original picture. It's still very visual and straightforward.